everyone, we're going to be reading a story called Listening with My Heart, which is all about kindness and self-compassion, how to look after and love yourself. Esperanza's tummy fluttered as she practiced her lines on her porch. Today was the class play. Waiting for Mama to walk with her to school, she paced back and forth when she spotted a heart-shaped rock. Esperanza picked it up and showed it to Mama as soon as she stepped outside. I see you have found a little treasure, said Mama. Esperanza rubbed its rough surface and felt a twinkle of joy. Maybe it's a sign. For what? Asked Mama. She thought about the class play later that afternoon, wondering what it would finally be like to be in the spotlight. To put my heart into everything I do, she answered. At that moment, they heard a scratching and a soft cry. Esperanza peeked under the stairs and spotted a kitty, shaking and shivering. No Mama in sight. She scooped up the kitten onto her lap and cuddled her. She's all alone. I think she's hungry. Esperanza reached for her lunch bag, pinched off a piece of chicken and offered it to the kitty, who gobbled it up right away. Mama, I think this is a rock to remind to spread kindness and love. And that's what we do when we listen with our hearts. I think you're onto something here, said Mama. Please, can we keep Cleocatra? Please, said Esperanza, who had already named the kitty. Queens are always welcome at our house, said Mama. If she's still here after school, we'll take her in. At school, Esperanza was more focused on the play than math or reading. Clutching her script during recess, she noticed Bao sitting alone on the bench. He was new in school this week and he didn't speak much English. She wondered if he felt lonely or scared. Esperanza found a soccer ball and kicked it over to him. A smile spread across Bao's face. He stood, popped the ball into the air and then bounced it between his knee and head a few times. Dude's got moves, thought Esperanza. They spent recess giggling and making up hand signals. Afterwards, Esperanza borrowed Ms. Owen's English-Vietnamese dictionary. She wrote friend in Vietnamese, drew a picture of Bao and her, and then put it on his desk. Esperanza rubbed the rock inside her pocket, and listening with her heart made her feel peaceful inside. Finally, it was time for the performance. It was too late for Bao to be in the play, but he stood at Ms. Owen's side as a stagehand. Excitement bubbled over as Esperanza waited her cue. Esperanza walked onto the stage and tripped as she was about to say her first line and splattered across the stage. When she got up, she had forgotten all her lines, so Ms. Owen whispered them to her from backstage. Heat rushed through Esperanza's body as all eyes were glued to her, and she wished she could just disappear. I ruined the play, thought Esperanza, rushing off stage as soon as she'd finished. I messed up in front of everybody. She tucked herself up behind some props so nobody would see her. Esperanza noticed that her body was shaking and her face was still burning. She took a deep breath and dug the rock out of her pocket. It was cracked and lopsided, just how she felt. Esperanza touched her hand to her heart and felt the disappointment. Bao found Esperanza a few minutes later and handed her a drawing with the word friend written above it. Esperanza nodded. She hadn't been treating herself like a friend at all. Esperanza realised that this wasn't the very first time she'd been unkind to herself. At the soccer game last weekend, she'd missed the ball that was swooshed by her head and they lost the game. Nice work, a player yelled from the other team and everybody laughed. Esperanza thought that she had let her team down and she was the worst soccer player in the world. Thinking those thoughts had made her head feel worse. At the curtain call, Esperanza reminded herself that she hadn't ruined the play. She had had an accident, and accidents happen to everybody. Listening with her heart wasn't just about giving kindness and love to others, it was also about giving kindness and love to herself too. I can be a friend to myself, thought Esperanza. When Esperanza got home, she focused on her favourite things. She zipped down the hill on her bike and then spent the afternoon painting at the kitchen table. She also got the hug that she needed from Mama and some cuddles from Cleocatra. Some days stink. Not everything will go the way you want. You'll get upset, and when this happens, you can pause, take a deep breath, and practice listening with your heart. You can name what you're feeling, and whatever you feel is okay. You can listen to your body and notice the sensations and feelings that you're having, and pay attention to your self-talk. Are those words supportive and kind and understanding, or are they mean or rude? Are you being a friend to yourself? When we treat ourselves with the same kindness and understanding we give to someone we care for, we are practicing self-compassion. Wrap your arms around yourself and give yourself a gentle hug. Take a few deep breaths and close your eyes if you'd like, and say these words to yourself. When I feel sadness, may I treat myself like the friend I need. May I show love and kindness to myself. When I feel anger, may I treat myself like the friend I need. May I show love and kindness to myself. Think of the feelings that you experience that are difficult for you and fill in this blank. When I feel, may I treat myself like the friend I need. May I show love and kindness to myself. The end.